We all think she will have it.
Can I ask if an officer could turn this noise thing off the call as I can? It's being said every once in a while for me. Can I ask everyone's voices?
Welcome all to this evening's meeting. I'll just very briefly run through the opening of the business I see and one of the new conversation. Obviously, our purpose today has to be to introduce the past minutes and consider two items, two main items we're considering, or the one and the third. These are the retirement of the chief executive. You've all read the papers, and you can see that set over on pages 15 to 56, with recommendations on page 19. That's the gist of it, that's where we are, what we're there to do. We aren't, as in either case, to actually make any of those decisions, only to establish the panels for the purpose of placing on the date. So if we're all happy to proceed, I think we would appropriate to ask the best items to give us a sound. Yes, are there any declarations? Oh yes, I did mention that we had minutes. I think you've all seen minutes of the meeting.
Yeah, well, I was there at the
Okay, so we get on to the main business then.
Thank you, Chair. The first substantive item is concerning the appointment of the Chief Executive and Head of Paid Service, including Returning Officer and Electoral Registration Officer. For the purpose of brevity, I will refer to this post as Chief Executive from here on in, rather than adding in the additional responsibilities of the role. The report outlines the issues for consideration by this committee, and they're detailed on page 15, paragraph 2.3, where we work through setting up a performance panel, determination of whether to use recruitment consultants, determination of whether to use professional advisor for the panel, the growth of salary for the role, and job description for person specification. Search process and timetable. In dealing with those issues, there are a number of recommendations, and the recommendations are outlined at paragraph 14.1. So, Chair, my suggestion is that you take those recommendations for this particular post step by step through the recommendations of paragraph 14.1.
Thank you.
Thank you. A bit before we get to the recommendations, Alan. Couple of questions around it, because again, page 18, item 5, talks about other options considered, and it says all options outlined in this report, which actually doesn't cover some of the options I'm going to cover. So, I think a couple of questions really. Have we thought as an option for those instances whether we need a chief executive? Strategic directors. So, do we need a chief executive? Is there any potential for sharing a chief executive? So, if the decision is we need to have a head of paid service, it has to be a person above the other three, then has there been any discussion about the potential for sharing a chief executive? I know one side of the administration is keen on sharing services, so I wonder whether this was in fact a perfect opportunity for us to think that through. So, equally, when we talk about salary, I won't talk numbers on this, but it talks about the salary as per, somewhere between 1, 2, 2, 4, 3, members before we get on to the question.
I would say possibly in opposition we change it.
Sorry, are you making this? Well, I was starting the conversation. I was thinking some discussion backwards and forwards, and then maybe a proposition might emerge.
Yeah, well, obviously, Jeff's kind of, this has been kind of trailed in some of these questions that were trailed in the press. Just a personal view, I do believe we need a chief executive. I'm not of the view that, you know, we're the ninth largest metropolitan council in England, we're the second largest council in the city region. You know, we provide a massive range of services with a substantial budget, and we've got some pretty significant challenges going forward. I don't believe that it's appropriate for us to move forward without a chief executive running the organisation. I don't know of any other local authorities in the North West that are running without a chief executive. Don't know if you would, Jeff. So my personal view is, we, given the scale of the operation, given the challenges ahead, I do believe we need the chief executive. On the issue of sharing the chief exec, clearly there's parts of the country, I think London have got three boroughs that share a chief exec. In the past I've heard you eloquently speak against sharing a chief executive. I don't know if that's still your position. I suppose, you know, my view, having kind of reflected on this, I think there's a point I remember you bringing up, Jeff, when we had this debate last time round. I would worry if we shared a chief executive just how much time, energy, focus, commitment that person would have on rural issues compared to if they had split their time between rural and one or two other local authorities, given all the factors I've talked about in terms of our size and our challenges. So, I suppose my, again, personal view is, I kind of share a position you previously held, which is we are sufficiently important enough to have our chief executive in our own right. I mean, just in passing, I note, we've got two other Merseyside authorities that have recently parted with their chief executive, and St Helens, they advertised their chief executive post just last week in the Municipal Journal. St Helens are a much smaller local authority to rural, but they've advertised for the chief exec. So I think for all of those reasons, my own view is, I think we are sufficiently important an organisation to merit a chief exec in our own right. I would worry that sharing chief exec would dilute the focus on purely rural issues. And I suppose on reflection, I would want our chief exec just to focus 100% of their time on the challenges that we've got and moving us forward to being an excellent organisation. So that's my
view. Okay, well, there are two quite distinctly different views. Phil, as you want, can you try and have the other view on this?
You mentioned something on the third point when you came in, and I wanted to understand what was said as the third point when you came in, somebody else, you know, leaving whatever the time. I'm not sure I heard that correctly, so if I can be told that, so I can actually hear it, that would be very important.
Certainly, yes. since this was legit, we have become aware that the Director of Resources has also attended resignation and will depart from us during December as well.
Is that section 151?
That's your view.
Yes.
So obviously, that's not quite the same as the first item.
I was aware of certain matters to do with that, but just aware of the situation. So what I'm puzzled about, what I'm trying to look at, is things in context. First of all, people will probably take this wrongly, but they are. I'm not sure that the job that was set upon 2.5 years ago was actually going to be completed. So we left a little bit up in the air with an unfinished business, unfinished work. So that tends to suggest there's a scale of problem to be addressed because Will's problems have been solved. So that leads me to say, well, we need somebody who can do it. And therefore, I understand the point about having enough time to do the job, especially with the difficulties that I see lower down the pecking order. Now, those difficulties lower down the pecking order are very rehearsed many times and improve upon someone who really has a problem. Second thing that does strike me, though, more powerfully, is that we're not the size of organisation of workforce we were a few years ago. Nor are we not the structure we had a few years ago. When the cabinet time stuff was embarked on a savings exercise at the top of the organisation, which was put on hold while the people lower down have had the pain and so on. And therefore, there's a lot of unfinished business and still work to be done. That leads me to ponder on the pressures on staff going down. And to try and summarise things, we've been busy urging people to leave and also degrading them. And from what I read in emails from staff and what I read elsewhere, the various degrading exercises having worked consultants in that mean that people are generally recognised. Therefore, I then think about the representation we've had over many years now about the difference between the top of an organisation and the people at the bottom. About what the difference is, what the number of times the top salary is compared to the bottom. That leads me to suggest that we need to do a bit more work on this. And that's why I thought in terms of reference in the appendix 5 weren't comprehensive enough. Now, my version of appendix 5, which is going to page 35, was to explain because in that section we refer to the market, the size and the scope of the second five right phrases. It's in clause 1 of appendix 5. Am I reading from a public document? I think I have to check.
Yes.
So, that what equally could read the changing market, the reduced size, and reductions in the size of the workforce and revised downward grading of staff, if it was to be fully comprehensive. We've been given figures for the councils in the North West, and I'm not sure that's in the public domain as well. That's much more news. And what doesn't help me is this, apart from reading about Mosley and all the press, all these councils appointed people at a certain time, possibly when things were really good, possibly, if you give us language, when things were on a roll, and salaries were on a roll, and now we're in different times. So, I'm going to balance whether we sort of wander around with our sort of hair shirt like St. John the Baptist and old cloths and things and say, right, we do it as modestly as possible. So I look at the crisis for staff there and think, well, actually, compared to Rochdale and St. Andrews in the air, none of these, I don't know when they last did them. And I say, they might have now, I'm assuming the chief executives went on to say, if the organisation is reduced in size, they don't take the most amount of people. They still on that because they're appointed on that. So I don't know what the other authorities are doing if they reduce their size.
Can I just make a comment?
Yes, I'm sorry, it's a long dissertation, but these are both looking at it.
Thank you. It's a long It's long, but it's always good. It seems to me that that really matters to the panel we have to consider.
Well, yeah,
that's its job.
Right.
So our job is to appoint the panel.
Yes. So if we appoint the panel with particular terms of reference as set out in Appendix 5, we need to adjust Appendix 5 and take account of the views expressed by members. Otherwise, we're considering Appendix 5 in a narrow definition.
We wouldn't want that to go beyond the scope.
Okay, anyone else? Phil, what are you talking about? I mean, I think all the points that Phil's raised, which are, you know, I think are worth discussing, are covered in terms of reference. You know, yes, the market has changed. I accept that in the last 2-3 years. But how can we take beyond on that? I don't think the words in this
in this terms of reference, which are pretty broad actually, preclude us discussing all of those issues that Phil's raised, which I think are reasonable points.
Okay, Jeff, I'll let you come back on that.
Yeah,
we have to move through some comments.
Yeah, and just to the points that Phil was making in response to just to start the conversation with that actually what Phil said comes to bear on this, that actually there are that the council has changed by its nature since we last had that meeting. It's a standing committee in some cases, but that seems to be last went through the process and we left a few upbringing and achievement. The council has changed and it's changed and it's changing. So there was an issue that I'm prepared to accept the argument that there should be a troika, there should be a single person as the head of the paid service. What I didn't hear that the reasons why possible should be something about the people's responsibility in terms of people should be able to say if something's going wrong, that's the person that should be accountable. But I still don't think that stops us from looking into the opportunities to see if there is a the opportunity to share a chief executive. I would just say, and this is where the conversation starts, reading through this document, is that other options considered, this is all options outlined in this report. Now, the conversation we've had would suggest that those options can be considered. Now, you know, I listen to you with great understanding. I'm always keen to hear what you have to say as leading the council experience person who's been on many of these points. And so that's interesting, that's good, and you probably do share a number of those. But there's a difference between your view and my view, and what's actually written down here about whether there were any potential to actually do that. So I don't know whether the outgoing chief executive Graham has looked at whether there were potential opportunities. I don't know whether Chris in a role as HR and OD has looked at whether there's any opportunities back from this report. It doesn't even suggest whether anyone's really thought about it, looked at it, and said you can do it this way or actually you shouldn't do it. So, because that's not considered. I do think that's a bit of a weakness in this report. And so, if we are to progress, and I think we do need to. One of the things I would be suggesting is that we should add another item onto the terms of reference, which would be that the panel receives call from the current chief executive and the head of HR and OD on whether there is the opportunity to share a chief executive. So that would be something that the panel would consider. Clearly, at the end of the day, it would be a recommendation of council. But in terms of giving the amount of authority that's been delegated to this panel in order for it to recommend, again, it seems to be a reasonable change.
I just think we've got both of those officers here. I think it would be useful, maybe I can ask the chief executive all his views on, you've worked in this role for 2 years. Blackburn for a number of years, you know the sector very well. Be interested in your take on the idea of sharing.
Chairman, I'll say maybe probably after this meeting, I'm something that I've been involved with. The normal tradition is that the retiring chief executive is not part of the appointment of the SAS successor. So if I've been once you've set up the appointment panel, that would be the end of my role in this process. So I suppose, so if you ask me to do something. Normally, it wouldn't be part of beyond this meeting, but obviously, clearly, it has to be kind of respond pretty fast. In terms of sharing our options, I think you are correct. I don't know of any authority of this size outside of London that shares a chief executive. rather want two district councils in the south, and we have the ones who district councils in the northwest, like you have to for a short period of time, mushing between current. So my personal view is, given the challenge that Wales has got, and all the clubs have got, which is another challenge, it would be a very, very tough task for anybody to bring council this size or this challenge to everybody else. So my personal advice is, the only thing I would like to say about the appointments, and again, the panel made its own decision on these things, because I've got no interest in it in what sense, I wish as a view that an incumbent's salary is too low to attract decent candidates across the North West. I say the top thing for me, it doesn't affect me anyway, it's a professional opinion, I'm not saying necessarily towards the top end of this range, I wouldn't support that, which I would advise that. But I do think there needs to be some increase in the salary and the 20% to attract the right candidate.
Okay, well, I think we've been difficult here. I think we should
get on to
it. We should add the request for a paper produced by the from the current chief executive and the head of HR and everything. And good enough one and what's that? A paper to that panel for us to consider whether it's an option that's worth further consideration. So I would formally move that that should be added to the added to the terms of reference.
And there's a second. Okay, let's take put that to the vote. Those in favour? And those against?
I would say that just so it's